really believe in existence of Allah, that is attributes. You really believe in the existence of angels. You really believe in the institution of prophethood and messengerhood. You really believe in the revealed books. You really believe in resurrection after death. If these are real beliefs, if you believe in these things from the bottoms of your heart, then it is iman. Now, is something added to the fundamentals of Islam when a person has reached the level of iman, faith, real faith, personal conviction? Yes. What will now be added is jihad fi sabilillah. Jihad fi sabilillah is not a pillar of Islam. Please note it. It is one of the two essential pillars of iman. Additional iman will have all these five: the attestation and the prayer and the salat and obligatory charity and hajj. Along with these, two will be added. In addition to this verbal attestation, real belief, you may call it the ultraviolet. And on the other side, jihad fi sabilillah. You may call it infrared. That is the proper color for jihad. So these are the distinctions. Now a mu'min must fulfill these seven conditions to be called a mu'min, real mu'min. In addition to five pillars of Islam, real belief, personal conviction in those articles of faith, not only verbal attestation, and jihad fi sabilillah. So now I come to jihad fi sabilillah. I really wanted to make one point, that the basis of Muslim society, Islamic state, is Islam, not iman. But what will matter on the day of judgment is iman, not Islam. You might have been accepted as a Muslim in this world. You might have been a leader of the Muslims in this world. But if you don't have iman, and Allah knows it, He knows what is in the hearts. We can't decide. In this world, we won't decide about it. But Allah knows who is real mu'min, who is real believer. So on the day of judgment, only the good acts and virtuous acts of those people will be accepted who had the real faith. If the real faith, the real iman, the conviction is not there, no deed will be beneficial. Now coming to jihad fi sabilillah, it will take some time. Brother Afsar said that it is very famous. I say it is very infamous these days. Very wrong associations with this term of Islam. But all the wrong opinions basically are based from our own mistakes, mistakes of the Muslims themselves. Number one, first mistake, we equated jihad with war. Jihad means war. War for the cause of Allah. This is wrong. Quran has two terms. Jihad fi sabilillah, qital fi sabilillah. Now jihad is from juhd. Juhd in Arabic means to strive for something. You are exerting yourself to achieve something. This is juhd. And jihad means struggle. There is some opposition and you are struggling against, striving for جهد and struggling against is jihad. In the same way, some person was going and you shoot him. This is qatl, murder, assassination. But when there are two groups facing each other, these people want to kill them, they want to kill them. Now this is qital. So jihad from jihad, qital from qatl. And now qital fi sabilillah, killing people, fighting against them, for the cause of Allah, is qital fi sabilillah. And striving something for the sake of Allah is jihad fi sabilillah. Now based on this misconception is the second error. Because jihad is not there always. Qital is not there always. So it became a secondary thing in the conceptions of Muslims. We call it Fardh-e Ayn. No, it is not Fardh-e Ayn. Not it is the basic duty. Whenever there is war, well, go and take part in it. That's all. Not necessary. All the times. No. While Quran says, there can be no iman without jihad. I quote ayah number 14 from Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah 49. Now I am quoting ayah number 15. From the same surah. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. Verily the true mu'mins are only those who believe in Allah and His Messenger. And then they have no doubt about them. It has reached the level of personal conviction. وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And they make jihad with their belongings and with their lives for the cause of Allah, in the way of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. Only such people are truthful if they claim to be mu'min. So there can be no iman without jihad. In the same way, in Surah Al-Saff, this surah is 61, and I am quoting ayat 10 and 11. يا أيها الذين آمنوا هل أدلكم على تجارة تنجيكم من عذاب أليم. O you who believe or profess to believe, should I lead you to a bargain which will save you from the punishment, the painful punishment of hell? If you want salvation, what you have to do? This is the question posed by Allah, and then He Himself is answering. تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Have real faith in Allah and His Messenger. Now it is very important here. The first ayah starts with يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So this is some other iman. And now they are being asked, تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. You should have real faith in Allah and His Messenger. وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. And make jihad in the way of Allah with your belongings and your lives. So, I have made two points. There can be no real iman without jihad.